Well, a Portsmouth woman has been reunited with her lost dog, Mickey the Boston Terrier. Went missing more than 6 months ago. His owners had just about given up until they spotted Mickey just a few blocks from their house. And it turns out he wasn't lost, he was stolen. Jennifer Gannon joins us now with that story.
Well, Tom, Natasha Curtis was at a Dunkin' Donuts drive-thru down the street from her home last week when she spotted a Boston Terrier and immediately recognized that it was her missing dog.
This is Mickey, the 8-year-old Boston Terrier. He's back at home with his family in Portsmouth after an ordeal that started last winter.
My 5-year-old let him out, which we didn't know at the time, and like a couple minutes goes by, whatever, and it was really quiet in the house, and I'm like, where's my dog?
After reporting the dog missing and putting up signs, the Curtis family thought Mickey was gone for good. Until one day last week when Natasha Curtis spotted him being walked just down the street from her home by a man she didn't recognize.
I yelled out his name, and the dog, Mickey was pulling the guy and the two dogs, and I ran around the fence, and the dog just kept on wanting to come to me. I knew it was my dog.
Curtis approached the man to get a better look at the dog. The man then called his wife, Alice Giordano, to the scene. After an argument over who owned the dog, police were eventually called. After interviewing Giordano, police determined she had found the missing dog and was keeping it as her own.
There's nothing to indicate she made any good faith effort at all to try and do anything to locate the owner.
After Mickey's microchip checked out and police were able to prove that he was the Curtis family's dog, Giordano was arrested and charged with receiving stolen property. The dog was then given back to his grateful owners, who say they are so happy to have their beloved pet home.
He's never going to get out again. Nope, he's definitely ours. Come on, Mick. Come on. Give it up.
Now, we weren't able to reach Giordano for a comment tonight. She is out on bail and is due in court next month. Reporting live in the studio, Jennifer Gannon, WMUR News 9.